Hello, everybody. How's it going? And welcome back to Supreme Ruler Ultimate. Now, if you go into single player and do scenarios, and you go to custom, you'll notice there's a bunch of new ones. There is 1936 Race for the Nuke, which there's no information or anything on yet. I don't think if you go to the Soviets, yeah, there's nothing else there either. But yeah, apparently you can race for the nuke. I guess you would win tech score. Yeah, okay. That makes sense. Tech score, because nuke would be pretty damn up there, if not some of the last. And then they have these arenas. So there's arena 12A, 4A, 6A, and 6B. And there's just different countries and stuff that you can play as in each of these scenarios. This one is islands, which is fine. And then this one here is all North America. I've played this one. It's basically islands scenario. Like if we say, it doesn't really matter which one we go into, because I'm just going to show you what the map looks like. Done. But it's this. This is not, that isn't Ontario, nor is that where Quebec is in the world. What the fuck? They're loosely all connected too, which I like better than the islands one, because the islands one, everybody just kind of defends themselves on their one fucking port. And even if you have, like, a massive army, they're just going to defend it with theirs. And you have the disadvantage of supply. So you have to basically outnumber your enemy, like, 50 to 1 to even have a hope of getting in there, which I really hate. But anyway, this one, they're all, like, attached, or at least mostly attached. Or they can become attached. So I think the only one that isn't attached together is Saskatchewan, which is on their capital and stuff is all on this particular island, and this is detached, though you could build a bridge very easily from New Stephenburg over to Pantsfort. And really, guys, are you fucking really? And this is why I say I think it's not done, because look at all these fucking names. Amazing. Absolutely amazing. The capital of Ontario is Battle Goat, because that's where Battle Goat is based. So har har. Burling Castle, Oaktown, Yorkfield, Sunder Castle, and I believe Quebec's is York. Yeah. So yeah, those major cities. You start off as each of these pretty even, you know, population-wise. You can see, like, you know, Manitoba over here has a lot more larger cities than, say, Alberta does. So, yeah, they're pretty even as far as, like, population goes. Each starts with one production facility, naval, is what I meant to say, and land. So that's great. And from what I can see, too, you have to research ships and air on all of them, too. You'll have multiple infantry and stuff ready to go, but you won't have any air or naval production facilities, I assume, with the exception of probably Saskatchewan, because, I mean, yeah, if I was going to bet on any of these guys being a naval power, Saskatchewan would be the one that should be a naval power. But anyway, pretty neat. I played this one. I played it as Ontario. I won. It didn't take very long, because it does do the hyper-fast, holy tits, craziness. So, you know, a game can go pretty damn quickly with this. Really fun multiplayer. Is not, honestly, really fun on the multiplayer. But if we go back, oh fuck, not the sandbox scenario, and we go back to custom, there is 12A, there's 4A, 6A, which is islands, and 6B. So 12A, you can play as these beautiful North American, these beautiful European, or these beautiful Asian. So if we pick, say, Hong Kong. Well, boom! Holy tits! You got a bit of a bigger world. Now, that obviously makes sense. Also, I find it hilarious that Battle Goat City is in New York. Where the fuck am I at? Hello, Hong Kong. Fuck is my capital at? So that's Southern China, Massachusetts, Taiwan, St. Petersburg. Oh, there I am. I got a decent amount of land. Holy shit. But yeah, it looks like it starts off kind of the same. You've got one of each. This time I have a patrol ship, though, so that's nice. I don't have anything there. And I have, yeah, the basic shitheads. So yeah, and then you can play as that. I love how Moscow is Zen Castle, and it's just off on its own little fuck-off island. That would be the first place I'd be taking over. Which one of these cities has their seaport? Do none of them have a seaport? Uh-oh. How the hell are you supposed to get on this fucking island? Are you serious? Obviously it's not done yet. They're going to have a seaport. Otherwise you're going to have to invade them and just build a bridge. You could do that. Just have a navy and out-navy them. Mighty Sunderton. Apparently Sunderton and Wolver and Victoriaville. Battle Goatstead. I'm starting to wonder if these were like randomly generated and they just kind of went with it. But yeah, you can see it's like, you know, obviously not done. I wouldn't want to live in northern China. That place looks fucking depressing. Although they have a huge amount of land. Yeah, the Western Urals, and then there's New York on an island here. There's Volgograd in a not a great place. Honestly, it's Hong Kong here. I feel like I'm set up for success because I've got Volgograd with these stupid amount of cities here. Basically a fucking oversized city state. And then I've got St. Petersburg with their capital right there, so I can just invade both of them super quick and get a shit ton of people and new resources. Also, Moscow owns that island there. But yeah. So that looks cool. And if we quit that one and go to the other one. Single player scenario. Go away. 1936. Can we go to, what was it, 4A? Yeah. We'll just be Moscow. Who fucking cares? And here we are. Apparently that's all I can scroll out. So yeah, there's Moscow, Taiwan, which George apparently is a fan of, Massachusetts, and Marseille. And that's what you have. So depending on how many people you have playing your multiplayer game, I guess, you could play one of these maps, which would be pretty fun. It's different. They're pretty wide open, too. At least these ones are, and the last one was. So that's pretty crazy. It's neat. I like these like map. I hope they keep them and these aren't just like experiments for the map creator. Because I think that's what they might be. And then of course Race for the Nuke, which seems like an actual official one, because it has a fucking name that makes sense, and has the technology. Advancements. So if we go fastest, yeah, see, it's traditional. We have all of your normal nations. Easiest way to win this one is to be either the United States, any kind of superpower, I guess, so the US, the USSR, Western Europe, and just take over all those other nations that are like first world, and then win the end. That's all you really have to do.
Excuse me.
Oh, sorry about that. That's pretty much all you have to do on this one, and because once they're out of the way, nobody can even come close to you tech-wise, so you just essentially just spam warfare tech until you get nukes, and you're fine. There you go, win-win. Fuck you, everything else. yeah, it's all good. It looks like it could be a neat scenario. You know, Cold War could get hot with the competing nations and stuff, and you can put it on aggressive and all that kind of shit. So yeah, it could be an interesting one. I thought that said Aquanistan, not Afghanistan, and I got very concerned. Also like that Tibet is its own nation. Good for Tibet. Good for Tibet. But anyway, yeah, that's pretty much it. I just wanted to show off those, just so you're aware that they actually exist. Maybe I'll play a multiplayer game with one of them at some point, and people can, because they have done a lot of multiplayer updates, and I want to see how they work, if they work well, because they've done like the whole, the host quits, the game keeps going, they've improved the lag situation as far as I've been told, and that kind of stuff. So I just want to see how well that actually works now, and go with it.
Stop fucking yawning, apparently.
I gotta go have a nap or something. Jesus Christ. That coffee today. I haven't worked today. I haven't done anything. I've just been doing laundry. But anyway, sorry. Enough rambling from me. Thanks so much for watching, and I will see you all next time. Enjoy the scenarios.